Welcome back, Wellness Warriors, to the Entheogen Explorer channel. I'm Caitlin Thompson, and in this video, I'm going to share all about the amino acid L-tyrosine, which is used as a supplement to improve athletic performance, energy, motivation, and concentration. Now, before you run out and get yourself an L-tyrosine supplement, there's a few really important things that you need to know to get the most out of your supplementation with it. In this video, I'm going to be sharing with you a number of really important things, such as how to biohack the L-tyrosine pathway by pairing it with other nutrients in order to get the most out of your L-tyrosine, as well as L-tyrosine dosage and what to look out for if you think you may have taken too much L-tyrosine. Stick around till the end, because if you are going to be taking L-tyrosine consistently and have it as part of your daily supplement regime, there's something that I'm gonna share with you to look out for to make sure that you are using L-tyrosine in a safe and sustainable way. Now, if you're like many of us, you probably have a number of days where you wouldn't mind having a little extra energy and motivation to get you through. While caffeine can sometimes be helpful for giving you a little boost of energy and motivation, if we're drinking caffeine or coffee on a regular basis, sometimes we develop a tolerance, and when we need that energy boost the most, sometimes the caffeine is not enough to really get us there. L-tyrosine is a great caffeine alternative for those days that you need a little extra kick in the butt in your workout or your work day. L-tyrosine is a naturally occurring amino acid that is contained in a number of protein-rich foods, such as chicken breast, beef, eggs, dairy, nuts, grains, legumes, and other food. It's also a precursor to a number of really important neurotransmitters and hormones in the body, such as dopamine, norepinephrine, epinephrine, which is also called adrenaline, and thyroid hormones. The body can also make its own supply of L-tyrosine from the amino acid L-phenylalanine, or can get it from the diet. You can also use L-tyrosine as a free-form supplement where it acts as a natural stimulant and dopamine booster. Many people will take L-tyrosine before they do a workout to improve athletic performance, energy, and also mental clarity and cognition. Some studies on tyrosine have shown that it helps mitigate stress and helps our cells adapt to things like high altitude, cold exposure, and stress from exercise. If we're experiencing emotional stress that's draining our levels of stress hormones such as adrenaline, L-tyrosine can help us restore these stress hormones so that we can return back into balance. In the body, L-phenylalanine is converted into L-tyrosine. Then from there, L-tyrosine can be converted into L-dopa, which then turns into dopamine. Now, it can either stay as dopamine, or it can continue further on the pathway and become norepinephrine or epinephrine, which is the same as adrenaline. The enzyme that is required to convert L-tyrosine to L-dopa is called tyrosine hydroxylase, which we'll talk a little bit about more later. Some people have a genetic condition called phenylketonuria, which stops them from being able to convert phenylalanine into L-tyrosine. Because of this, they end up getting a toxic burden of phenylalanine buildup in their bodies. But there is some evidence that supplementing with L-tyrosine is able to reduce this toxic burden somehow. Also, because they aren't able to make L-tyrosine out of phenylalanine, they need L-tyrosine as a supplement in order to make important things like dopamine, norepinephrine, and thyroid hormones. Understanding the biochemistry of certain supplements can help us get the most out of it. For example, if you want to get the most dopamine boosting properties out of your L-tyrosine supplementation, there are a few nutrients that you might want to consider pairing with L-tyrosine. So remember earlier I talked about the enzyme tyrosine hydroxylase that is super fundamental for taking L-tyrosine and converting it into L-dopa so that it can later become dopamine. Well, it turns out that iron, the nutrient iron, is actually really important for the production of this enzyme. So if you are low in iron, or perhaps anemic, you might not make enough tyrosine hydroxylase, which means that even if you're taking L-tyrosine as a supplement or getting plenty of it in your diet, if you're not producing enough of this tyrosine hydroxylase enzyme, this will actually inhibit your ability to make dopamine. This is generally the limited factor in the pathway and dopamine creation that stops you from converting your tyrosine into L-dopa. So be sure to get your iron levels checked before you do any iron supplementation to see if you are perhaps deficient or low in iron. And if you're not, then you might not want to supplement with iron because you actually can get too much iron. But if you're on the lower side of the, you know, normal range or perhaps even deficient, you should consider supplementing iron in conjunction with your L-tyrosine so that you can make tyrosine hydroxylase and turn more of your L-tyrosine into L-dopa. Another nutrient that you might want to consider pairing with your L-tyrosine supplement is vitamin B6. Similarly to the tyrosine hydroxylase enzyme, vitamin B6 is the enzymatic cofactor that converts L-dopa into dopamine. And it's usually also the limiting reagent that will dictate how much of your L-dopa actually turns into dopamine. So if you're doing all this work to make sure your iron levels are good so that your tyrosine hydroxylase levels are awesome, then also take vitamin B6 so that you don't create a biochemical traffic jam and just make a bunch of L-dopa and then have no vitamin B6 to turn it into dopamine. So you can take these nutrients together with L-tyrosine in order to sort of bypass these biochemical traffic jams, as we say. If you like the enhanced concentration and athletic performance from L-tyrosine, but find it a little bit too stimulating, you might want to pair it with L-theanine, which is an amino acid found in green tea that I actually made a whole video about also that you can check out, I think, on this side. And it's really nice for just kind of taking the edge off of these stimulating nootropic supplements such as L-tyrosine, caffeine, and other stimulants. And it actually has been found to protect against excess levels of dopamine. So sometimes if you're really sensitive like I am, you can feel a little bit like, shaky and jittery when you take L-tyrosine. So I really recommend pairing it with L-theanine just to kind of soften the edges a little bit and just take it one notch down. So typically people take anywhere from 500 milligrams to 2000 milligrams of L-tyrosine in a day. Now, you may be more or less sensitive than other people with it. So as always, I recommend starting really low and cautiously until you start to understand how your body is responding to it. And then from there, you can adjust and experiment with dosage. I'm actually incredibly sensitive to it. So when I do take it, which is rarely these days, I take maybe like 200 milligrams of it because I find it quite stimulating and I can be quite cracked out and like, you know, shaky and jittery from it. But I'm on the extreme end, so you probably will have a more normal response to it than kind of a weirdo. I recommend taking it in the earlier part of the day, especially the morning or before a vigorous workout, because it is a stimulant. And so you don't want to take it right before going to bed because you might have trouble sleeping. While tyrosine appears to be fairly safe, there is one really important thing that you have to watch out for. Now, as you may recall earlier in the video, tyrosine is also a precursor to thyroid hormones T3 and T4. If you have too high of thyroid hormone levels, you develop a condition called hyperthyroidism, which is a serious health condition that has a number of consequences. So you can actually prompt yourself to produce too much thyroid hormone from over-supplementation of L-tyrosine. This is sort of why I decided to stop taking L-tyrosine as part of my supplement regime, because I was taking it for a while, for several months, everything was going good, I felt happier, I felt quicker, quick-witted and energized. And then it was as if I just sort of saturated some biochemical pathway in the body and hit this like threshold where it felt like now my L-tyrosine was getting diverted into thyroid hormone, and I was experiencing symptoms of hyperthyroidism, like crippling anxiety and a lot of discomfort. I couldn't sleep. I was having like rebound effects. If I take the L-tyrosine in the morning, that night I would have horrible anxiety. And my partner at the time also actually experienced the same thing where, you know, he was enjoying the tyrosine and then one day it kind of like hit a point where it was like no longer giving energy. It was just like giving horrible anxiety and emotional discomfort. So our guess is that that's what happened, is we sort of hit a spot where we were kind of tipping the scale with our thyroid hormone production. So please, if you're going to supplement with tyrosine regularly, be mindful that it may increase and affect your thyroid hormone levels, and that this is not always a good thing. So watch out for that. Be sure to monitor how you're feeling on a day-to-day basis and take a break if you need to. So while I personally found L-tyrosine to be a little bit too stimulating, especially with these thyroid boosting effects that I was experiencing, I still wanted the enhanced cognition and focus from the dopamine effects of L-tyrosine. So luckily I found an alternative that worked really well for me, and I just kind of hopped up one step of the biochemical ladder in the dopamine synthesis pathway, and I started supplementing with Macuna Puriens instead, which contains a rich source of L-dopa. Now, as you hopefully remember from this video, L-tyrosine becomes L-dopa and then later dopamine. So because I still wanted the dopamine boosting benefits of L-tyrosine, I just kind of skipped over that step in the synthesis process and went straight to L-dopa, which I have found that the Macuna Puriens and the L-dopa in it is a much more smooth, like wakeful supplement for me. I found that the L-tyrosine was a little bit too sharp and too stimulating, and that the Macuna Puriens is a much softer, more sustainable and paced feeling of mental energy for my body. So in summary, you can use L-tyrosine to enhance your athletic performance, energy, cognition, motivation, and concentration. You can pair it with iron and vitamin B6 supplements in order to get the most dopamine boosting properties out of it, or you can pair it with L-theanine to just help you shave off that edge just a wee bit so that it's not quite as intense. If you find that the L-tyrosine is too stimulating for you, be sure to check out Entheogen's best-selling product, Transcend, has 17 different scientifically studied ingredients in it, including Macuna Puriens, vitamin B6, L-theanine, and a number of other amazing nutrients and botanicals helping to balance your brain chemistry. It also is great in adjunct with L-tyrosine, so if you do want something that you can supplement with L-tyrosine that does, for example, have vitamin B6 and Macuna Puriens with the L-dopa to give you an extra boost of dopamine, then that's an option too. It can either be a substitute or an adjunct to your L-tyrosine supplementation. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and be sure to subscribe to my channel if you love this sort of geeky stuff, because I sure do. I love to talk about biochemistry and neuroscience, especially in ways that are actionable, that help me actually do something to make my life better, to make myself feel good. So I hope that you enjoyed it. Subscribe, comment below if you have tried L-tyrosine. I would love to hear what your experience has been like. And I'll catch you guys next time. Smile on, my warriors. Mwah! In this video, I'm gonna share with you all about some people have a genetic condition called phenokidyl, can't say it.